Now we go Hidetsugu and Kairi. We take this one. Okay, man, like this will be interesting. So this is on top. You cannot mess it up. Now we bridge the multiverse and Boros doesn't know what's going on. So we need to survive then. And the Gitro. Oh man, we can draw so much. This is perfect combo, right? This is pre-combat phase. Hello everyone, it's Love here, and today Grixis with Hidetsugu and Kairi and both Bridge the Multiverse and Explosive Singularity. This will be extremely entertaining to watch because, man, we will chain the value infinitely and you will see some of the most epic games ever today. The deck comes from MagicCon in Amsterdam. This was played by one of the players and went absolutely under my radar. So I'm fixing this right now and sharing this decklist with you guys. And, man, Hidetsugu and Kairi is more fun than you remember, I'll tell you that. So let's go into games and have fun, guys. I really want to big score in between their spells, that's a huge deal. And we need to go for push and pull a lot of times, probably. Alright, I mean, the mana is prepared, so if they tap a dance step, we are going with the big score. Alright. So, what do we discard? I think it will be Marsh. We like mana, but we should draw something, see? Alright, that's good, that's good. That will definitely help with Normalize. And we don't want this exiled, we want it in the graveyard, so we can push and pull. Alright, so we got a small advantage, but it definitely won't be enough to win the game on its own. So, oh, Mirex. I think I need to wait one more turn, right? Because I don't have 8 mana to pay for Normalize, and I need this countered. Well, that's a good one. That is a good one. So our opponent is entering the best stage of the game for him, but we'll see. It will be rough for sure. They're absolutely packed with cards, but at least they need to play something, otherwise they need to discard. They might go for removal, but it is useful against our deck. Well, so, as far as they know, we might not play creatures, though. Alright. Discard. Down to 7. A lockdown. Correct. Let's go like this. We have 3 mana open, so that's a start. And they cannot double Normalize because they don't have card mana for it. So it has to be 3 steps ahead, probably with Cardo. Which is still great for them, but... but we have some opening, at least with push and pull. Let's sit. There is a chance they don't have a counter spell. It happens a lot, especially that you need a very specific one. Wow, was that really such a hard decision? Nothing really happens after they counter. They just get good value, and that's pretty much it. Alright, so Kenzan probably not great here. Let's start to push and pull. We still have 3 mana, so now it will get a little bit harder for our opponent. So we have the play for the next turn as well. Every time we have this 3 mana open, so they need multiple 3 steps ahead. Like, I think they need 3 in total in row. Otherwise they're risking a lot. Just be good at magic. Well. You know, this is kinda the game of... do you draw it? Yes. Okay. So we will see if he draws the third one as well. But his opening is extremely good right now. I don't want to burn the appraiser, it's not worth it, and the only creature is ours, and the one that we want to reanimate, so it's not a very good deal here. And they will pass the turn and play it again, probably. Alright, and we'll play it again. I mean, you get the game plan. We'll keep doing it until one of us wins. Let's see who draws better. Alright, here it is. That's the first one. We want to draw into the next one, probably. Alright. That's it. We need to hit a little bit randomly. Well, that's a cut down. Alright, kinda impressive, but we are going with it. So, I think we might cycle the last card. Edict is okay, but I think we go like this. Alright, do we need... No, no, no. We are okay with this. So we will just keep doing it until something happens, because we have big score right now, so we can cycle into Hidetsugu, possibly. Our opponent has Wandering Emperor. I think we'll kill it at the cost of a single thing.
I'm not overconfident.
It's not like they won't make a token, right? So we can do it now. So that's a start. They can absolutely go with Jace, but at this point we just need to roll the dice, right? And the 2-2 won't make a difference this game, at least not for a very long time. What makes a difference is having counterspell for each of our plays, basically. And we'll keep doing stuff like this, right? Is that the big score? I think so. I think so. We don't have a crew. Oh, we have? Okay. Then we keep doing it. Then we just keep doing it. Let's get it again. I thought it was exact. And they will probably kill it again. I don't think there's any point in using map tokens right now. We don't have removal yet. Alright. I mean, we are doing cards at least. So we will go... Oh, right. We know what the card is. Sure, let's play it. And token. They might use Mirex. But it seems they don't want to. Well, I wish we had this one. So, can I cycle? I want two lands on the top right. Just because I can possibly draw them with map tokens. I could play land. We have Path of Prayer to discard. So Kanzan is kinda nice, especially against the mites. Like, we can basically negate, what, 8 mana? So we will try with this. We will try with this. Another Emperor, sure. This one will get a little bit annoying. But we have Path of Prayer, so if they go for double minus one, I think we just sweep the board.
We must protect the people.
I mean, that's it. That's it. They want to memory there, so we want to really pressure them on this turn. I honestly think we go Sokanzan right now. Like, this will be annoying because they want to use Mirex, they want to use Memory Dirge, this kind of stuff. Do I want to burn a treasure for it? I mean, let's try. It probably won't work, but it might draw us a card, and that's kind of big deal. Alright, we got it. Nice, nice. That also means we can do it again. So we got some decent value from those map tokens. Alright, possibly an additional card. And of course we'll double attack and let's see what happens. They might have another Emperor, they might just ignore it and just go with a Memory Dirge. I think this is a Memory Dirge play. They're just taking damage because they want the big value. Alright, how many Hidetsugus we had this game? It feels like 5, but it actually was 1. Alright, so... I mean, they're only getting 2 cards, but probably they will take 1 Memory Dirge and something else like a counterspell, and then they will play Memory Dirge, and then they will play Memory Dirge. So they will never run out of value probably from now on. I assume this is a Memory Dirge at the end step. So... I mean, let's see if we hit a land. Alright, we're really good at drawing lands, man. Actually, with the map tokens, it's good deal. Wow, we actually drew so many of them. Alright, do I have a creature on their side? Nope. Let's go for damage. We have Singularity, so getting them to 20 might make a difference. And I think this should be a big score in between, or just cycling, lands, basically. Let's see what the end step play is. Well, this is okay. I don't mind Union. It's not great for us, but, you know, it's one of the low ball plays, basically. Let's go for a big score here. We don't need the cliff for sure. And, you know, we cycle, we get some extra value, we see what happens. Ah, not the best one. I honestly think we'll recycle at the cost of one treasure just to keep the tempo going. We could singularity, but Mandara at 29, so it will be a very long way. We probably need to draw more Hidetsugu. I think that's the idea. We take the damage. We'll play this one, cycle this one. And we got a target for Go for the Throat. Alright, that's it. Like, we have options, and Charlotte is interesting. Let's play the non-pain land. So, what do we go for? I think we go Charlotte and possibly Otawara. And we just see from there. They might have a lot of might tokens, so let's say this will die. Probably they will make one might token, right? Because the mana for the second one will go to the removal. And then we appraiser the Charlotte, maybe. I guess we could Otawara right now. I'm not sure what is the better one. That is a quite heavy tap. Let's go for it. Like, we need to protect our value, because our draw is not super strong right now. And we have nice blockers, so it won't be easy to attack, unless they want to invest more. I kinda need to burn them from all of those cards, which will be super hard. And this feels like an Emperor. Oh man, but I guess we need to force them into playing her. So if we get two of them, it doesn't make a difference, then we'll just lose twice as much, so... Right. Okay, this is better than I expected. I really thought that this would be the Emperor. Let's cycle land. Let's get this going. I mean, here's the bridge. Here's the bridge. But it would be very hard, man. We don't have very good plays here. I need more Hibutsugus. And we want to play everything at let's keep this one. At so many excess mana that nothing can be no more light. So we don't give them good value. So the best card for him is Memory Dirge right now. He needs Memory Dirge so he can refill. Because I'm trying to fight for the value, basically. Right, this is a weird play, but I think it's okay. I really want it in the graveyard, so my appraiser can hit better stuff. So on this turn, we invested a little bit more, but we get better though next turn. Okay, here it is. And we need to be careful about the exile effects. Alright, let's get rid of the Shorded. Because this doesn't have as well, this is really bad, man. Let's go for launch, just because we can cycle it. One Hidetsugu. Like, we have this one, right? So maybe if we go for bridge, we don't have enough mana. So let's go for this into the launch. Yeah, now we will actually exile this. But for a very good value. And our opponent, you can see that he is slowly starting to burn cards. He's down to 5. And the bat, sure. I will wait for the next turn of it. Like, this will be our opening play, so we know exactly what's up. And no point in attacking. They have a lot of answers. They even can use the Anchorage. We have so little mana that we cannot threaten a big spell if they tap out. Alright. Very, very careful taps. And they have 3 mana on top of Mirk, so I don't think they will Memory Dirge. I'm curious about the careful taps. In the end, they don't seem to be doing anything with this mana. Alright. 5 cards. It's not the end of the world for us. And I think they used already double 3 steps ahead, right? So they actually don't have as many as they want. Takenuma can be a very strong card. Listen, We are opening with the bat. Let's see what's up. I think they have a sweeper, but this might be the card that forces some reaction. I want to see the hand. Even if this dies, we still see the hand because they didn't counterspell it. And that will make it so much easier for us. Alright, map tokens are fine. I need to know if they have counterspells or not. See? We were playing pretty nicely around what he has. Told you. Told you. So we know they don't have removal right now. They have Field of Ruin. So if we put this on top or this on top, they just Field of Ruin anything. Alright. I want to burn through it. We will absolutely pay. Like, they need to stop a lot of mana for this. This also stops the Mirex. Alright. And now... let's go with this one, right? I think I will burn the treasure just to keep the map tokens going. Is that a good one? I mean, this is a decent draw. Like, it keeps the pressure. Do we want to deal 9 damage? Alright, I think if we do it right, we should get this, right? I'm not sure how to play it, to be absolutely honest. You know what? I think this is how we attack. We poke a little. Because I want to make sure that I'm kinda defensive. I'm at 12 with some poison things. And my next draw is very good. So generally we are kinda higher on the value right now. We have 21 cards. So they will play Jace. Minus 2. They will draw 4 extra cards. So it's not super easy. Alright, that's fine. That is fine. That makes our draws a little bit better for the future. But we don't have another land for Field of Ruin, and they can still, you know, shuffle our library after Hidetsugu. So I think we'll bluff and put 2 lands on top of our library. So, oh man. Well, this is insane, like, you know, blow to our game plan. Like, our whole game was taking them to 0 cards, and we're on our great way to do it, but suddenly 1 card and they will never whiff again. Well, this is a very good card. So we need to push for tempo a little bit. We know what they have, and 3 steps ahead is something we probably need to risk fully. Alright. Well, more than plenty, right? Oh man, I need to know my top deck. We need to see it. Hidetsugu and Kairi. So I guess at this point there's no point in using Takenuma. Right, I full swing. I want to make sure that I get them below 20. Alright, we did it. The Field of Ruin is such a big problem, man. And there are 25 cards, so we are not milling them. Alright, so what do we go for? I mean, I can Hidetsugu into Hidetsugu, but they will shuffle in between. I will also die, right? You know what? I think we can do this. I'm just hard casting it because we have 3 mana open. You know, that's something. Yep, I can pay. Alright, I guess I will pay. And that's a 10 damage. I never hard casted it, I think. Or at least not this year. Alright. They can go Memory Deluge, but they will have a lot of mana. So I guess I think they should win this. But I think that was a mighty attempt, you know? Alright. Man, they have just 1 card. Man, they have Jace, right? I'm sure they have Jace in the deck. So that means we mill 10 cards and then we go for Jace. You know what? I think that might work. Because we will be at 0 cards, but it doesn't matter because he needs to draw a card first. Oh man, I think this has a real shot at winning. Just please, no 3 steps ahead. They have 2 in the whole deck. I'm sure they have more Jaces, right? They only use one this game, and they play at least two, probably even three. Oh man, I think they are sweating. I think they see it coming. I'm pretty sure we should hit the Jace with this. The question is, do you have a counter spell? Alright, you know what? That's a good play. They can three steps ahead. I mean, that was kind of obvious, right? If you have it, you cast it. And he can take the Jace. Oh, I've seen Jace. Alright, we take it. What's from my... Well, I don't have a graveyard. And here we go. Here's your Jace, my friend. You like milling opponents? Well, we will mill you. You didn't think we'll win this, huh? Okay, that was official. Let's not play Hidetsugu, alright? And that's it. I was wondering if there's an upside to playing Sharded at the top of this. Oh man, that was a worthwhile win. Alright, we're going first. We have pretty nice answers. Definitely a lot of lounges, but this should actually really help. Right, we can curve out pretty nicely to 4 mana while having 3 mana open on turn 3. And we will need Path of Peril, it seems. So do we want to cycle it? We are getting a little bit flooded already. Listen, I will risk a Tapland later. Like, our mana is super healthy right now. Alright, 1. I actually don't... Well, they don't have red for Gleeful Demolition. So. I think we 3 steps ahead if they have Knight of Ales, and we kinda roll with it. And if not, we just cycle the launch. Like, we need some good cards here. We have things under control, but, you know, it might change. Okay, this is something we absolutely need to counterspell. I think we will go with Path of Peril on the next turn. Maybe we need to go into 7 mana to try to bridge the multiverse. It's interesting, they wasted 1 damage. No, they actually wasted 3 damage to get this scry. Okay, you know what? With this draw, I think we can go like this. We need to slow them down so they cannot convoke anything. Like, Boros scales like geometrically. Like, the more they have, the faster they can, you know, amplify everything. So if you cut everything, suddenly they, you know, that's a showstopper for them. And we need this extra turn to play Hidetsugu into Breach potentially. I think we're in a decent spot, honestly, but of course they will keep pressuring, they will never lack the value. You know, the standard Boros stuff. And honestly, I don't think they will kill it on this turn, but I cannot risk it. You know what the cool play would be? I could bridge them. Well, I have another one, so it's fine. I could put it second from the top. This would be the first one. And then on the next turn, we go for the throat, kill this. And this is on top on the next turn. But if they have case, like, they can resort to reinforcements into case and this dies. And I need to make sure that then I win. Let's get this one, maybe. Yeah, I need to make sure that whatever they draw is, they cannot, you know, dominate the board on this turn. And on the next turn, we can always play Hidetsugu and do it all over again, right? This is good for them, of course. Like, the Boros is one of the aggro decks that basically never runs out of gas, which is insane. But we will not run out of gas even more than them. Alright, so. I think this is it, right? We attack. Because good damage is good. Now we go Hidetsugu and Kairi. We take this one. Alright, so. Dice first. This one resolves, right? We draw first. Yep. Okay, man. Like, this will be interesting. Oh, right. It should be a land. Because we are triggering it on this turn. Yep. So this is on top. You cannot mess it up. Now we bridge the multiverse. And Boros doesn't know what's going on. We will take Hidetsugu and Kairi, yep. And on the other side, I think Novice Inspector, because it gives us Cardo in case that something is really going wrong. Alright. This is a dent. So first we draw three cards, we go bridge the multiverse, and listen, they're so calm, like they love it. They just want to see what's going on. So we will go this into this, right? Because that, and this is kinda insane. So this is on top, we cast it. Our opponent is not dead yet, and we are doing it again. You know what? Let's go with Epicure. And Bat. I want to kill them with their own Epicure while stealing their last card. I should reverse the triggers if I wanted to see the card. Alright guys, and this is how you kinda destroy Boros with this deck. Alright, we're going first. We will go with Xander's Lounge and we'll see. We have Charlotte with Path of Peril, so it should be interesting. And finally, we're seeing Golgari. Love it. Absolutely. Man, Golgari is one of my favorite decks to play and also to, you know, face against, which is great. I honestly think we need to go with Shores because this card is kind of devastating. We could get better Path of Prayer, but there is a chance they will draw so much that we won't like it. Stomper, interesting one. Is that a ramp? Maybe. Let's go with Shelly. Well, our 7 drops are kind of wild here. We definitely need Hidetsugu or Big Score so we can cast those. Right now we are just clogging our hand. Like, so we basically have 0 cards right now. What are you? Trainbraid. Okay, that's fine. They will go absolutely crazy on the next turn. But I want to deal damage because those cards, with Hidetsugu especially, can just, you know, burn them for refund. Especially if we can attack one more time. Don't forget you can convoke this, basically. It's worded differently, but it's still a convoke. Alright, Bronco, a little bit scary. You know what? Bat can be really good. I think I attack first. They also won't have enough life to pay for Bronco, so they need to saddle it. And they won't be able to burst us in one turn. I didn't want to cast the Bat because when they see that they won't make their cool play, this could change their decision. And I wanted to make sure I deal the damage. Well, at least that was definitely a surprise for me. I didn't expect two of them. I didn't really expect one of them either. Alright, okay, this is very, very scary. But I don't think they will kill me in one turn. Like, they don't realize how insanely aggressive our deck is. Like, we can burn them just directly for 10. And I wanted Bat because I think we can convoke enough. So, yeah, if we draw a land, we can convoke this and deal 10 damage. And that means a direct refund. Oh, right, I forgot. This also gets burned. And we can attack with the Bat as well. So they will draw a card, which gets them to... Well, they don't want to draw the card, right? By the way, I absolutely forgot about this one. But man, the Shorded is doing work. I didn't expect that this would be so much damage. Right? Saddling. More damage. Man, somehow they're drawing all the time and they're around 7 and 8 all the time. Sure, I will take a lot of damage, but... One good draw, and I mean a single land. Easy. And I'm just really... What? Wait. Okay, I'm thinking. I think we have breached the multiverse, so it's not over, but wait. So if I play this, it's 8 mana, I have 7. Oh, it's already modified, because, okay, that makes sense. So it's 10 mana. So yeah, we are, oh man, that's a little bit sad. So we need to survive then, but it should be okay. Right, on our side, we take Hidetsugu, right? Because if they attack, that means they are dead. And the Gitro, oh man, we can draw so much. This is perfect combo, right? This is pre-combat phase, all right? I put this and whatever. This is on top. I draw so many cards. Man, this is insane synergy. And I can saddle it. With Hidetsugu. Are you serious, man? Oh my god, and we go like this, and I mean, well, no, no, no. I need the car, though. Does it work like I think it does? Should I read the card? Did I need to deal damage to the face? To a player. Okay, I got way too excited. I got so excited I forgot to read the card. Alright, so I needed to deal damage. So I guess I should just block. That's not perfect, but we'll kill our opponent anyway, due to Sharden. They can deadly cover up and kill everything, but then would they die? So if they kill Hidetsugu anyway, they die instantly. If they let us untap with it, like, I mean, that's kind of the same. We attack, we can even destroy tapped creature with this one, or just, you know, push and pull something from our graveyard. Like, we will have options. But man, I kind of butchered it. I was so excited. I thought that it will just get sacrificed anyway. And yeah, our opponent just doesn't have the answer to what we have. And they are too low to, you know, fight. Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed those games, as man, each one of those were pretty epic today, so I hope you had a great time. This is best of 3 list. I didn't remove the sideboard because I know some of you play best of 3, and this is from a tournament, so why wouldn't we take it? However, what about this in best of 1? Well, I'm kinda, I have mixed feelings after playing this. There are some games where you just curve nicely and you have so many plays that everything goes perfectly and you feel like the deck is insanely fun and insanely powerful. However, you also have, you know, games where you don't draw Path of Peril and your opponent just rolls over you, and yeah, then you are like, well, I didn't want this kind of game. And so honestly, I don't think this is the best choice for best of 1. However, the deck is surprisingly fun to play and very satisfying, and it can absolutely, you know, fight against those decks, but I think on average you won't be favored. I don't think this is a great deck to ladder unless you just want to have fun. So, you know, Hidetsugu and Kairi together with Explosive Singularity and Multiverse makes for some insanely, you know, surprising plays. Also with push and pull, you can kind of force Hidetsugu dying, which is a big deal as well. So you have ways to outplay your opponent super hard, and I think that's one of the reasons I enjoy the deck so much. But yeah, probably not the deck to grind to Mythic, alright? Unless you want to have a lot of fun. So I hope you appreciate the, you know, the honest review on this one. I'm a little bit sad that it didn't go well. Like, I think we ranked up, but it didn't feel like it's a ranking up deck. You know, it felt that we are on the lucky side a little bit. So yeah. Wouldn't hold my breath on the results, but I would hold my breath for the excitement of playing this deck. So yeah, it's time to wrap it up. Really thank you for watching, guys, for all the comments, for all the, you know, excitement about those decks. Like, it's such a big part of making content for you. Like, I'm just curious what you will say. So leave me a comment, don't be shy, and thank you for watching. You are extremely appreciated on this channel every single day. And yeah, that's about it. So see you guys tomorrow. We'll be right back.